Hello, everyone. Welcome. You're listening to Kimla and Company on Beacon of Light Radio. I'm your host, Kimla Dodds. And for those who are just tuning in, watching, listening for the first time, you may not have heard of me, but I've been on the radio doing radio for about 5 years. And Beacon of Light, we started this up, oh gosh, well over a year ago. We're the new kids on the block, so tell a friend, tune in. We have great shows. This is Triple Crown Thursday evening, and we are June 14th, 2018, and the moon is in Cancer, and we are all snuggly buggly. I know you're probably wanting to cook at home or do some fun things at home tonight. You know, Cancer rules the home. And I've been into astrology since I've been 10 years old. So taking different courses, and you know, I studied at UT. I've also studied the Chinese version of astrology. So I call myself an intuitive astrologer, and I'm also a psychic medium as well. And I fell into feng shui actually through one of my professors at UT. She introduced me to the concept of feng shui back in, I know, I hate to say this, but back in 98. And so I was just blessed because I was able to get into the very, very first class of feng shui out in San Diego, California, that was taught by then Professor Lin Young, who actually went up to Grand Master before his passing. And my advanced classes I took with Lillian too. And I'm sure if you have ever dabbled in feng shui, you probably have been attracted to her books, because her books are just fabulous. The photography, the information. She makes it very simple for you to learn feng shui. So all of my advanced classes were with Lillian too, and her beautiful daughter, Jennifer. So if you're interested in anything like that, please go to my website, kimladodds.com. Check it out. You can click on my web store page, and I have all of my services there. And I do run some specials. I'm running a special for Father's Day in June. So if you have an inkling to purchase a Father's Day gift, the special is going to be running just through the month of June. So make sure you check it out. It's kimladodds.com. And you can read all about me, all about what I have done. I'm also an author. I have another book coming out very shortly, and I'm going to be promoting that, and that's coming up, so I'm excited about that as well. So we've sold out, I think, on two of the books, but there is, you know, one book left, so you can go ahead and check on that as well. So good evening, everyone. How you doing? What's shaking? How about that new moon in Gemini, right? Super moon. You know, it's kind of funny, but all of the moons and the eclipses and everything are really going to be very, very close to Earth, to Mother Gaia. So they labeled them as supermoons. They are going to be felt a little bit more intense. We've had a beautiful water trine, so any of the water signs out there, you've been having some fun. You've been having an easy road. You've been looking good. Yes, you have. And now with this, you know, beautiful new moon in Gemini, we've, you know, on that particular day on June 13th, just yesterday, we have had the new moon in Gemini, and also Venus, the planet of love, has gone into Leo. So what does that do? That gives you this warm, fuzzy quality. You know, Leos are so affectionate. They rule the heart. I mean, that's their organ that they rule. So they rule the heart. They're very generous and giving. And with this coupling of Gemini, the twins, we've got this partnership going on, and this beautiful, warm, fuzzy, adoring, dramatic display from the heart. So we've got this beautiful communication that's happening from the heart. Do we have some other players in the mix? Well, of course we do, because we have had this terrific energy of Uranus coming up, and that's been in play for, you know, on and off for the last couple of years. But I have to say that when we take a preview of the week ahead, we call it here on Beacon of Light Radio the Star Update. So we're going to begin with the star update. And like I said, today is Thursday, June 14th, and the moon is in Cancer. I have to say, it's Flag Day in the United States, and we proudly display our flag. I have little ones. I don't have the real big ones, but I have the little ones. So today was Flag Day in the States. You know, Beacon of Light Radio is an international radio station, so we have shows from all over. It is such a global unit. You can listen to shows from down under, from Australia. You can listen to shows from the UK, from Norway. You can listen to shows all across the United States and Canada. So we've got this eclectic group. And what do we all have in common? We all study energy. We all study metaphysical subjects. So make sure that you do yourself a favor. We've got lots of different ways to tune in to Beacon of Light Radio, whether it is by an app or downloading it. We also have our archive shows on SoundCloud.com. And I want to say a shout out to my producer, Charity Minton. She's going to be putting this podcast up, I believe, on YouTube as well. So you can be tuning in, listening in your car, or watching us, or however you feel more comfortable about catching the information right here on Beacon of Light Radio. So with the star update for this week, I got to tell you, we got a great week coming up. And this is kind of the shift that's going to start happening, because we've had this easy way of going. We've had some wonderful Neptune energy that fills you with intuition, psychic awareness, inspiration, creative abilities. I'm telling you, it's just been one of those times when if you've wanted to go forward in some of these creative things, this is the kind of fairy dust, the little glitter that hangs in the air that we can just, you know, say, oh, wow, you know, that really, wow, that makes me want to get up in the morning. That makes me want to finish my project. That makes me want to go forward, you know, like step by step, I'm going to really get to the end of this. And it's going to be a fun ride. So a lot of you may have been feeling that lately, okay? If you have not, come on over to Facebook. If you have not experienced our Facebook chat page, come on over, because we've got a lot of people lining up, and all you need to do is in the upper left-hand corner, type in Beacon of Light Radio Chat, and our chat page will fly up, and we've got a wonderful heartwarming group here, and we're kind of supportive of each other, and we've been going through this for months and months and months and months together. We've got a great group over there. I want to say hi to everybody in the chat room. And if this is your first time, come on over, and Charity will let you in and be part of the group and let your light shine. You know, we call us the beacons so that we can shine our light with each other, you know, mix it up. We are a powerful group. And I would love to see your questions, your comments. And also, you know, you can always call into the show as well. If you would like the number, you're going to need something to write on. So the number to call in tonight is 126-0222. 6490. Again, the number is 126-0222-6490. We also have a conference ID number, and that number is 640-14485. I know that was a lot of numbers, but if you jotted them down, I'd love to hear from you. Come on in. We're also going to be talking, when we finish up the star update, we're going to be talking about the topic of how do you handle or what do? When you have an anxiety or stress, you know, a lot of us get into situations where, you know, how do you handle that? Maybe we can swap out some things that work for you, and somebody else can try them as well. So please contribute on that topic after the break. So you know what? With all of this astrology, this cosmic weather coming at us, this weekend is really going to be a great weekend. We're gearing up here in the States for Father's Day. So I want to say happy Father's Day to everybody out there. You know what? I have to say that you know, I usually pick one day out of the weekend for date night. And Friday night, we've got a little action going on for Friday night. So I kind of, you know what, I kind of say, well, we've got Mercury, which, let's see, Mercury is opposing Saturn, which is in retrograde right now. And Mercury is in Cancer. And so Saturn is in retrograde, still in Capricorn. This is kind of the mom and dad kind of opposing each other, you know. The mom is very yin with the Cancer. The dad, it's the dad energy, the patriarch energy, and that's the Capricorn, Saturn, the discipline. So we've got kind of this thing going on. It does build up. So I feel like Friday night is more like a family night or taking care of things to do around the home or around kind of responsibilities or duties that you may have. I feel like date night, oh, it's Saturday night. Hands down. We have got Venus is in Leo at 3 degrees right now, and the moon's going to be going into Leo. So I just feel like that is a fabulous, fabulous, warm date night. You know, it's just one of those nights where you want to get dressed up. You know, Leos love the drama. They love fashion. They also love children as well. So if you wanted to take your kids out on a date night, take them to a nice restaurant, it'll be really a fun outing too. But I think that, you know, sometimes, you know, people ask me, well, you know, I'm on this this computer dating thing. What's a really good date to set up, you know, for my first date? So I always include that every week in my show as well. So I think Saturday night is it. So Sunday we're going to reserve for the dads out there. And so Sunday, yeah, is Father's Day. And, you know, we've got so many planets in retrograde right now. We haven't really had that at the beginning of the year. Every single planet was going direct, and that's really something. Usually there's always one planet going retrograde, which means that particular planet's energy is turned inward a little bit more, not as dramatically obvious on the outside. But right now, I mean, I have to tell you, if you're doing a lot of inner work, it is because that we have got so many planets in retrograde right now. Saturn's in retrograde, Pluto's in retrograde, Jupiter's in retrograde in Scorpio. June 26th, we've got Mars going into retrograde, and also on Monday, June 18th, we've got Neptune going into retrograde. So we've got all of these planets that really are, you know, slowing down, turning around, and it gives off the effect that they have really turned inward so we can do our inner work. Now, Neptune is really a big player on Monday when it turns retrograde. And I have to kind of go over a little bit with you because when this happens, Neptune really rules, it's having a big effect right now on the chart of the United States if you track it. And so for the next couple of months, while Neptune is going through this inward type of orbit and journey, we are going to see all of these planets work into kind of a concert to really reevaluate, redesign the values in the United States of Americans in general. You know, a lot of people aren't going to like it. I'm going to tell you that right now. A lot of people are going to find it very difficult to reevaluate everything that they've known before, their values. And so we're going to kind of come up to some bumps in the path. Let's just put it that way. Because in July, Mercury is going to be going into retrograde. So we've got this whole carnival of retrogrades. So I have to say that we are literally being redesigned. Our DNA is being redesigned. It's being upgraded. Basically, the way we communicate is going to be upgraded. Mars is going to be going into retrograde. So, you know, and Mars usually only goes into retrograde for probably 4 to 6 weeks a year. It's going to be, you know, retrograde for like 4 months. So it's really going to be something else. So we've got, we've got Mars in Aquarius, which, you know, Aquarians is that Uranus energy. And I've got to say, or Uranus, however you want me to say it. But I got to tell you that this particular energy causes a lot of inventions, a lot of creativity, a lot of high tech comes in. So you're going to see a lot of upgrading on the way you communicate, the way you do your work. And it is going to be one of those Uranus right now is in Taurus. So it's going to be one of those things that comes in, breaks through a very fixed type of a sign that's a very, you know, heavy duty earth sign. And the thing about it is that, you know, Uranus has this energy, it's almost like electricity. It comes through on such a high frequency that it causes little electrical shocks to our awareness. So it may seem that as all of this retrogrades are happening, that there's a lot of chaos taking place. But inevitably, when we have so many planets turning retrograde, it's almost going to feel like, okay, they're all going backwards. So it's almost going to feel like a united flow, if you will. Okay. So it's not going to feel like just one area is going to be kind of, you know, messing up in your life. It's going to be this big upheaval. And then all of a sudden, it's just like, okay, you're going to have to be so flexible in order to go with the flow and to be and to really be centered that it's going to be kind of the norm. All right. And so one by one, the planets are going to start turning direct, and we're going to get into that. But this particular week on Monday, when Neptune goes inward and turns retrograde, I want you all to buy yourself a dream journal. Keep it by your bed, because your dreams are going to be a way that this particular electrical energy is going to be connecting to source. Okay, so when you are sleeping, this dream time that Neptune rules is going to be absolutely, it's a game changer. It's a life changer. It's going to make you so aware. So give yourself your dream time. You know, give yourself your daydreaming time as well. When all of these planets start turning retrograde, you have to be very, very kind to yourself. If you do not meditate, this is a great time to participate in meditation. It's a great time to learn how to center yourself, because if you are centered and you are streaming source, you are going to be easily rewired for this huge upgrade that we are being launched into during the summer. And definitely, we are being launched into it all summer long. So I'm kind of excited about it, because as we come up to Tuesday, June 19th, oh my gosh, we've got Mercury, the planet of communication, the planet of business, the planet of commerce. That's going to be trining Jupiter, even though Jupiter is in retrograde. This is one of the best days of the month. So if you want to launch something, you want to sign some paperwork, you want to, you want to present a proposal, you want to have an interview, this is the day to do it. You want to take an exam, this is definitely the way to do it, because Mercury is just going to be pushing behind you. If you need to, let's say, give a speech or present someone, if you're selling something, Tuesday, hands down, is the way to go. It's also a great day to put pen to paper. Okay, so if you've been holding off on, let's say, a mortgage or a refi or to sign any kind of real estate papers, I'm telling you, it's one of the best days. So for anyone out there that's wondering, gosh, should I go ahead with my closing? You know, don't be upset if on Friday of this week, like tomorrow, if the bank doesn't have everything all lined up according to kind of funds exchanging in real estate. And just relax, take a deep breath, relax, and just go, okay, Tuesday's great. Tuesday is going to be such, what I want to say, angels are going to be flying around and just blessing everything that really is in contract and signed on Tuesday. So I really do like Tuesday. Okay, Wednesday, June 20th. We've also got Mercury that's going to be trining Neptune. And like I said, Neptune by this time is going to be in retrograde. This is going to be one of those wonderful times if you are of the creative arts, if you are a painter, if you are a songwriter, if you are a makeup artist. Okay, this is when you're really going to experiment with new ways of doing things. You're going to have such an inspiration. The words for songwriters and poets, they're just going to stream together. Okay, for anyone who does advertising or jingles or anything like that, that is going to be an absolute beautiful day. So reserve that particular day. If you are writing a book, if you are a photographer, this is the day when maybe you would like to go out into nature and, you know, take some wonderful photographs. You're going to catch some absolute excellence through the lens on that particular day. So I love that particular day as well. And then we've got the sun entering into Cancer on Thursday. You're going to meet me right back here, aren't you, next Thursday on June 21st, because we've got a lot of good things going on. When the sun enters Cancer, we have something called the summer solstice, and this is when summer begins. And many people, I can't tell you how many people have not gotten into the habit of celebrating the beginning of summer. And it is something to celebrate. It is a shift. It is something that the planet that you're living on is actually tuning into a new frequency, a new season. And for that, it really makes our particular energy, our vibrations, our blossoming time, especially in the Northern Hemisphere. It's something where you begin to come alive. If you are in the Southern Hemisphere, you, at this particular time, you feel as though, okay, this is the time where we begin our rest. But on the planet, even though you're blossoming up on the Northern Hemisphere, you're resting on the bottom. This is how Mother Earth breathes, okay? She breathes in and out with the seasons, with the daylight and the nighttime. This is how the breaths come and they go. And there's different things that are happening in the summer. There's different portals that open up on the Northern Hemisphere, different portals that close down in the Southern Hemisphere. There's different pathways, there's different angles, there's different ways of using the cosmic weather to your benefit. If you are interested, I'm an energy worker, and if you are interested in how this accumulates and goes through the body, you can always book a session with me remotely, or I'm calling the show right here from Austin, Texas, but it's a great time to use some light resonance healing, which is body work. It's the light grid within the body. And what I do is identify and I light up your light grid within the body and I remove all your blockages. I kind of take out the dust, so to speak, all the things that your body has, you know, the extra baggage. This is the time to lighten your load, but it's also the time to reconnect the light and the nerve endings that perhaps have been frayed through improper eating or stress or injuries, surgeries, things like that. It's a wonderful time, especially at this particular summer solstice, to do that kind of work. So this is it, and it's great. And I can tell you, I've had so many people say to me, oh my gosh, you know, the work that we do remotely, it's not just for an hour, it's not just for a day, but the culmination and the healing takes place over weeks at a time, so you can actually hold more light. You can actually channel more information. You know, information comes in many, many different ways. It comes in pictures, photographs, frequencies, sound. It uses all of the senses. Perhaps it comes to each and every one of us through a different way or a different source. But to really, it's almost like, you know, recharging your battery. And what a great time to do that. So, you know, throughout many, many, many generations, thousands and thousands of years, people have celebrated the solstice. And whether it is the winter or the summer solstice, it's a beautiful way to get your ritual on, to get your ceremony on, and to really welcome in a new frequency. You know, every time we have a solstice, it is an upgrade. It is a new blossoming. It is a new shift for our Mother Earth and our planet. And there are many new things that are coming at us this summer. I cannot tell you. But I would love to introduce you to your birth chart and to tell you how your life purpose is being reworked into your journey. Because your life purpose, you know, you've started out with some contracts and some agreements. And as your life unfolds, you have gone through many, many different experiences. And I feel like so many people are now relaxing into the flow. They're not as solid. They're more open. They're more open. They're feeling the information coming through them. They're enjoying life a little bit more. Okay, so every time we get one of these shifts, there's a little bit of what I call entunement time. Some other people call it chaos. But while we are tuning in to the new frequency, it can come in many different ways. You can feel your body shift. You can hear maybe a ringing in your ears that you haven't felt. You can perhaps feel different parts of your body go through some, you know, some little pockets of movement that you've never felt before. Your sleep patterns might be thrown off a bit. During the summer solstice, also, the veil is very, very thin to the other side. So you might have some messages from your loved ones, or perhaps your ancient guides that have contracted you to really kind of introduce you on a higher path towards your life purpose when you get into this attunement time. And this is what we're all facing. We're all facing an attunement time. I just was shuffling some cards, and I don't know if you can see it or not, but this particular card just kind of flew out of the deck, so I want to introduce it. It's begging to be on the show. It is the card of Apollo, and it says, focus upon your strengths. So through all of this new energy that's coming in, Apollo is a god that wants you to really find your strengths, honor your strengths. You know, we all have vulnerabilities. We all have, you know, places in our life where maybe we feel like we totally suck at stuff, you know, or we don't even want to look at that. We don't even want to tempt that. And sometimes, you know, the things that we do very, very well, like our strengths and stuff like that, we take for granted. And we just go, oh, I know how to do that, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, some of us are wired for challenge. So it's kind of like, yeah, I know how to do this and I know how to do that. But give me a challenge because I want to learn something new. But in order to really be successful at any kind of challenge that is presented unto yourself, you have to know how to incorporate your strengths so that you can use every bit of what you have in order to get to where you're going, in order to take those particular experiences and, you know, register success, and also so that you can share your strengths with others. Because what you are very, very strong in could be just the thing that somebody is labeling as a challenge for themselves. So, you know, take some time and work with Apollo. Yeah, work with Apollo, because he's definitely there and wanting you to, you know, accentuate the positive a little bit and use your strengths for not only for yourself, but to be in service with everybody else around you. So this is a great week coming up. We've got some wonderful, wonderful things to look forward to this weekend. And during the week, we've got, oh my gosh, we've got great days on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So happy summer to everybody coming through and celebrating the solstice. I've gotten away from my drum circles that I used to do because a lot of my friends and my members from my group, we've all kind of gone our separate ways. But, you know, contact your local metaphysical chapters in things. Here we have the Austin Alchemist, and they introduce wonderful news and offerings of services. And we have You know, we have the psychic fairs, of course, but we also have full moon and new moon celebrations and drum circles and shamanic journeys. We've got a lot of herbs and a lot of recipes, a lot of new ways of putting together oils and combinations that give you that really give you kind of a what I call a natural edge. Some of that edge really is very soothing, and some of that edge is exactly what we need to kind of boost us and wake us up and enjoy the particular journey that's coming this summer. And we are going to be reworked, rewired, and we are going to be facing autumn in a whole new light. So come along with me, and I'll take you step by step, week by week. I'd love to work with you and your particular chart, because you are uniquely you. Nobody else is like you. Nobody else has your combo, your recipe, your strengths, your weaknesses. No one else has your karma, right? That's right. Nobody else has your karma, and no one else has the appetite or the curiosity to go ahead and do what you want to do. Experience something new. Experience a new perspective. Get to know yourself. Once you know yourself and the weather that's around you, it's amazing how fun your journey can be. You're listening to Kimla & Company right here on Beacon of Light Radio. And also, I want to shout out again to my producer, Charity Minton, who is just doing some wonderful things behind the scenes right here at Beacon of Light. We have opened up some new shows. Please go to our main page, our home page here, and schedule in your reminder to really tune into some really new and wonderful shows that we have, that we've got coming up. Okay, we're going to take a short break, and when we come back, I'm going to be discussing different ways of handling stress and handling nerves and nervous situations. And you know, a lot, you know, all of us have experienced, you know, the dry mouth, the clammy hands, you know, kind of the shake, the uncontrollable shaking when we get to the point that, oh my gosh, I'm so nervous, I'm so stressed, I don't know how to focus or funnel this particular energy that's coming through me. So we're going to ask the universe to kind of do a little secret trade with everybody, and perhaps we'll have everybody else chime in on what they like to do and how they like to recenter themselves, and how they like to channel the energy of stress, anxiety, and nerves. We're going to be right back, and until then, just hang in there. Get yourself something nice to drink, or perhaps a little comfy, a new comfy place to listen. And this is Kimla Dodds. We're going to be right back.
Introducing Wheel of Life magazine. Now more than ever, we're looking for meaning and purpose in our lives. We want wisdom on how to empower ourselves and live it. Wheel of Life magazine. Real people, real stories, bringing you inspiration, motivation, and empowerment. Find us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Wheel of Life magazine. Available online now.
Are you struggling with the loss of a relationship in your life? Has life given you a few challenging obstacles recently? I can help. This is intuitive medium Jennifer Fezzio, host of Spirit Talk. As a certified life, relationship, spiritual, and bereavement coach, we can together navigate through your challenges. Please reach out to me at Facebook/MediumFez or blessingsandguidance.com to schedule an appointment. Also, you can find me at beaconoflightradio.com and click on Beacon of Light Readings. Thank you for listening to Spirit Talk.
And we're back. You're listening to Kimla & Company, only on Beacon of Light Radio. And I want to say, hey, this is Kimla Dodds. And I want to say a little shout out to everybody in the Facebook chat page. Hey, everybody. So nice to see you. Thank you so much for tuning in. I want to say hey to Jennifer, and I want to say hi to Deanne Frost. I want to say hey to Maria and Sheila. And Vanda said something so nice. Vanda Guzman is her name. And she said something so nice. She said, you know, from our session together when I was doing her chart, she said, I found out truths that I would have never known before. So there you go. You know, you really don't realize the impact of having an astrology chart done, because that is really your unique imprint, like I said before. But there are other things that you know, that you really don't understand as well, as far as, you know, how your mother and father come into play, and why it is that you have gone through experiences at certain times before, because your chart is always changing. And so it's one of those things that you've got your natal chart that you were born with. This is your imprint that you have. It's your soul imprint for your time, your lifetime here in this particular time frame on the planet. And then you start evolving and you start going on this journey, and the tracking of that is just, it's mysterious, but it's exhilarating at the same time. I can't tell you how absolutely fabulous it is, but it really is. It's miraculous. So for me to be a little bit of a help, or my service is to make you aware, to make you aware of exactly what that is, that is really my privilege, and I love to make it fun. That's what I like to do. I like to make it fun. So astrology is really, really fun. You know what? I'm kind of combining a couple of things tonight as well, because we're here in the States celebrating Father's Day, and just to give you a little tip that I did not share when I was going through the star update. It's a feng shui tip, and I am a feng shui consultant for over 20 some years. Been doing a lot of house clearings lately. Yeah, a lot of house clearings. And with very, very good results as well. It seems as though the summertime is when there's a lot of exchange of real estate. People are selling, people are listing. People are perhaps moving into places that they've rented for a while. I've been clearing a lot of places, and I have to say that that is one of my specialties. So I have flown all over the planet in doing that, and I am available for that particular service. I remove imprints as well. And when I talk about imprints, they could be energetic. They could be a passing of an imprint as well. So there's a lot of different energy shifts within your sacred space. And it's very, very important that once you start studying energy, whatever it is, whether it's Reiki, Feng Shui, astrology, tarot, whatever your energy is that you're studying, and how whatever gateway you're using in order to channel this energy, it's really important that you honor unseen energy that is not working for you. You know, it can be a really, really easy ride, and it can be a lot of fun. So if you're having stress, if you're having blockages, barricades, those kinds of things that are coming up for you, or if you are having strange things, you know, go bump in the night and wondering why is that, if your particular success or your children have just, you know, have just having a hard time, you feel stuck, you've moved into a place that's not working for you, you were very successful, you bought a bigger, nicer, newer, you upgraded, and you're just not happy there, there's got to be a reason why. So that particular house, that sacred space, that office space has a chart of its own. And so what I do is I introduce you to that particular chart. I go through the space, remove what is unwanted, what's not working, what is clearly not in your frequency. And and it's just like a breath of fresh air. So we also do some rearranging and feng shui and things like that. So that's really a lot of fun, especially in the office. It's immediate. It's absolutely immediate. You know, when I work on shops and I work on people's businesses, they tell me that within hours, the energy is unstuck and the register is moving right along, and it's singing its song. So it's definitely something to think about. Okay. So my services are there as well. Have you ever thought of having a psychic party? I do that. It's really fun. You can go on Skype or FaceTime, and you can invite all your friends over, and you can have me, Kimla Dodds, right there at the party doing readings. And all you do is you sit down in front of the screen, and I'm there, and I read faces, I read palms, I read cards, I basically just start channeling information that come in through through my higher source, my guides, and also the angels that are protecting and around us, and the ones that will come forward and work with me. They're fabulous. And so I do that work as well. You know, in the news lately, we've been having a lot of talk about how do you handle stress? How do you handle depression? How do you handle anxiety or nervous situations? And suicide comes up, that word suicide comes up, and I have to honestly say I've dealt with it personally. When I went through dealing with personal experiences of suicide, the universe sent me so many clients for healing, for reaching their loved ones on the other side, for getting questions answered. So through my psychic mediumship work, I have gotten a different perspective on exactly, you know, what happens or what frame of mind people are in when this particular label is put on them for their transformation. It's one of those things that, you know, this is a planet of free will and free choice. A lot of times we're not choosing with a clarity or with our with really our direction in making good decisions at that particular time. So when I talk about depression, when I talk about perhaps stress and how we do that or getting to that point, I have to say that a lot of times the people who are really experiencing anxiety are masters. They are masters at cloaking it, at disguising it, at not wanting to talk about it, really in denial that they even have it. So this is the kind of thing that we take little baby steps. And if we can recognize when we're off center, if we can recognize when we are stressed or when we are experiencing anxiety, these are the first little simple steps that we can take to pull ourselves back into center, to really really kind of know when we are, as Abraham Hicks says, when we are out of the vortex, right? When you are out of the vortex and you're experiencing perhaps something that's not really called clarity or not willful choice or not direction, proper direction of energy. This is something that, you know, once we learn that, okay, now we're, you know, now we can tell the difference when we're in and when we're out. You know, that's step number one. When we recognize the fact that we are nervous, uncontrollably nervous, uncontrollably carrying a lot of stress, when we are going against our will, what we will do, what we will not do, when we are compromising our values, we bring on this type of condition. And you can call it whatever you'd like, but sometimes we just have little spurts of it when we're not in control. So it's kind of like, oh my God, I gotta, you know, I've got this interview, so that you get this rush of nervous energy, or I've got to perform, or, you know, I've got to do something that I don't feel comfortable in doing, but I have to do it for my job, or this is what I've been waiting for the whole time, but it's something that I haven't done before, so it's a new experience. You know, those are kinds of things that perhaps can give us that burst of stress, of nerves. Sometimes we have to handle situations or experiences that come up in our lives where, you know, it's a stressful situation, you know, health concerns, changes in our monetary flow, whether it's a job or whether it's a an expense that we have to put out for, or, you know, is our automobile, you know, our vehicle, we have to do something, you know, where, wow, you know, now I've got this big expense, you know, I'm stressing out about how I'm going to pay my rent or how I'm going to, you know, pay my insurance or my mortgage or whatever it is that we need to do. Also, time limits, you know, sometimes, you know, you've got the schedule, let's just say you're a family, you're trying to coordinate with, you know, with the children and with your husband or your partner, and you're trying to coordinate your schedule, and all of a sudden your schedule gets changed and you're like, oh my gosh, you know, how am I going to do all of this? You know, stressful situations come up on a daily basis. If we know, you know, how to control them, or how to really be in our center, how to recognize that, oh my gosh, I'm stressing out about this, or whatever that is, you can capture your energy a little bit more. And I've learned this because I've been on this route where I've been, as I always say, going Mach 10 with my hair on fire most of my life, you know, burning the candle at both ends, you know, that kind of a thing. But if we do a couple of things, I think, number one, just being aware that we're in the situation of anxiety. But there's a lot of professional performers, whether it is musicians or whether it is Olympians, the Olympic athletes, I want to say, whether it is actors, you know, you have gazillion people watching you. How do you prepare? You're going to be nervous, especially if this is maybe the first time that you're up in front of a crowd, or, you know, maybe this is the first time you've had to perhaps take on new responsibilities and you're not sure of yourself. You know, there's a lot of different things that people have kind of come forward, and they might work for you. I know a lot of people try to visualize, you know, the interview going great, being very successful. A lot of other people visualize what could really happen, like what are the circumstances? What are the questions they're going to ask? Especially if you're going to be taking, you know, a very important exam for like a license or something like that. You know, you kind of want to go into that anticipation mode of exactly figuring out each and every circumstances and how you are going to react, okay, on those kinds of things. So if you can project it and you can visualize it in your mind, you are going to be somewhat more prepared than perhaps if you just walk in ready for any type of experience. So a lot of people go through that visualization. A lot of people use breathing, the breathing techniques, meditation. A lot of people yawn. You know, yawning is an instant relaxation. A lot of people stretch. You know, they stretch out. They get the flow going. A lot of people jump up and down before they have a performance or if they're feeling anxiety. A lot of people sing. Yes, a lot of people sing. You know, sing like nobody can hear you. Yeah, absolutely. People have good luck charms, or perhaps a good luck tie that they wear for an interview, or good luck shoes, or they place little money in their pocketbooks, or different things like that. I do know an Olympic skier, and what does she do? She goes around, she hugs trees, and she talks to nature because her sport is outside. So she talks to nature. And she does that kind of a thing. A lot of people go into prayer. They go into a higher source of themselves, their higher self. A lot of people ask for guidance from above, those kinds of things. Yeah, there's a lot of different things that people do when they are in a stress type of mode. And, you know, and then we can go into, you know, having a glass of wine or, you know, a cocktail or, you know, some people use medicinal purposes. Some people, you know, smoke marijuana. Some people think, oh my gosh, I really need something like that. You know, you've got to go through a couple of different types of options before you find what brings you back to your center. And I'm not here to judge one way or the other, but I'm here to make you aware of when you are off center so that you can use an option. You can use one of these techniques that perhaps will bring you right back into center so you can be streaming your strengths, streaming your energy, lit up to your full potential so that you can actually make willful decisions on a dime. You're that flexible and you're that much in control, right? That much in control, that your reflexes are sharp, your brain is operating, and you are all you. You are just going forward directly, all you. So take a little tip from all of those people who are performing at a very, very high level and see if one of them works for you. I'm going to meet you right back here next Thursday when we are going to be celebrating the summer solstice and the sun is going to be entering Cancer. I'm so excited. Thank you so much for coming along with me this hour. I sure do appreciate it. And for all of those that are really looking forward to a beautiful summer, give yourself permission to be reworked, rewired, redesigned from the inside out. Until next time, may the angels protect you and guide you. Good night, everyone.